How you?
All right, awesome. All right, well, thanks for having me on, Coach. Good stuff here. I'm going to talk about a little bit of pressures tonight. Just keep it short and sweet and go over a couple things that we do here at Hoover. I think it's important that we start out with just kind of identify with who we are and what we do coverage-wise. So for us, we're a 3-4 defense. Some people say it's slant and angle, but we do move the front every snap of the ball. But our base install is what we call bench four. We're field and boundary related defense. So, but we're a quarters team when we bring bench, and we're playing 404 where our ends are head up on the tackles and nose head up on the center. And our big thing is, like, everything is built off quarters coverage. And we want to make everything come from quarters coverage, how we mirror it, how we disguise when we rotate into, you know, our post coverage versus our split field coverage as well. And then, you know, our hot blitzes, which I've talked quite a bit this offseason about. But I'm going to talk about some other pressures tonight that we do. Just give you a couple things if you're a 3-4 guy or even a 4-down front. I'm going to show you some things that we do. But this is what we did. We started this week. We've been going all week at 6 in the morning. This was the first week back down here in Alabama. And so it was good. It was really good to get back. And we've just started out really simple, really slow, and have built this in. But we are bench four. So for us, this will be a left cover four, meaning that we're bringing the bandit. Our boundary outside backer from the off the edge. He's what we call our six technique, and we're moving the front from left to right in this, and we're playing our base quarters coverage package, which we're a big two read team, or what some people refer to as palms, and then we'll play several different things to 3-by-1 as well out of quarters. You know, where we poach the safety, or we may play mini and cone on the backside. But that's our number one install, is our bench four package that you're looking at. And then the second install that we have is our field three, where we're a post coverage team. And we try to make it look as much like cover four pre-snap, make quarterback read it post-snap. And this is, you know, this would be an example where we would call right three, where we're bringing this, what we call the star, which is our nickel type kid, outside linebacker, to the field, where he's coming off the edge. And then we're dropping the bandit into coverage, and we're rotating to cover three here. Our strong safety is rotating down as our seam curl flat. Our Mike is our strong hook. Our Will is our weak hook. And our bandit, we teach him, we swipe the flat. We match the hip angle of one. So I think it's important to, you know, how we build these pressures is we want to live in that world of where, you know, my big thing is, you know, what can our kids do well, and how can they play fast every week? And, you know, if you've watched any of our film this year, our kids play extremely fast. And, you know, but we don't deviate a lot. We build off of these things, and we take some tools out of our toolbox that we might tweak it, but we're going to live in that world. So then from our three down with the field to the right here is how we get into our four down front. And all this is for us is bench show cover four. And we call it buzzard. So any of our bird fronts are we're showing four down. So all we do is we line up where we would be slanting to from odd into even. So our boundary end ends up in a three, our bandit's in a five, and then our nose can play a 2-hour shade. And then we slide our end to a five technique. So that's how we get into our four down, and then I'm going to show you some of our pressure off of that and how we do that. And then bear is another thing that we do. When we get into bear, both our ends, our two ends that went from fours, they go to threes. We walk the mic up off the edge, and he's now our five technique. And then our bandit is also our five technique. So, and then our wheel is in the box. So those are some of kind of the fronts that we're going to show you, but then we build off of that. So kind of the simplest pressure that you know, where you're showing four down, and this has been around for a while, but it's been pretty good to us, that we do is built off of our buzzard, which this is a show front. We're showing buzzard, but we call this fox. And I talked about this with Coach Vass not too long ago on a podcast. So for us, we're playing post coverage, so the call would be right fox three. So we're bringing the star from the edge, but we're showing the buzzard front. We're showing our four down. We're going to shade the nose. We're going to bring the three, the end down to a three, and we're going to walk the bandit up out of into our even front. And we're playing cover three. So it doesn't deviate from our, you know, base rules and how we play things. Everything's kind of mirrored in the secondary. But what we want to do is we're going to take our five technique across the face of the tackle. Our nose is going to, what we call, we're going to pick across. Our three technique, all right, he's going to work to a four eye, and he is playing the B gap. And then our bandit obviously is our C gap player. But if we get past, we'll play some tight front too. Our four eye, he is what we call, he cops out to, he's going to contain on pass. So we call it a cop technique. Now for us, when we drop our bandit in coverage, we swipe the hip angle of number one. Okay. We're pushing to the hip angle of one. So for example, if it was like a now screen or a fast screen, our angle should match the hip angle of one when we swipe out. But we're really trying to get out there on quick game and the hip of one. If there's no quick game, we ask our bandit to, once he gets to the numbers, he's going to hinge and elevate, and he's going to sink, and he's going to look for work or try to sink, climb underneath the comeback route out of one. And then our wheel backer is our weak hook drop, but typically he's a two dropper. So pretty simple package there that comes out of our cover three package. So this is an example here. Of where we go ahead, we get three by, we're going to go ahead and play it just because of the split. So we want to make it look like cover four across the board here. And because the split of three is tight, we feel like we can bring the star in here instead of exchanging it off with the mic. And we're lined up in the four down, and we're just playing post coverage. So bringing the star off the edge. Let me go to the butt shot, but you can see right there, we're in our cover three. This was early in the year. So we're in buzzard, we look like buzzard, where we've got our five, we've got our shade, we've got our three and our five here. And then we're just gonna pick across, we're bringing the five across. We should be bringing the nose across, and we actually went through this today. The nose was wrong here. And then we're working to a four eye from our three technique on this side. So you can see here, pretty good job. Now the nose, really bad job right there. So my mic, our wheel linebacker, because we're plus, he's now the play side A gap, number 41 there. But the nose doesn't come across. You know, he gets those dirty eyes in the backfield. All right, but four eyes, pretty good job right there. Three, picking to a four, I'd like to stay inside that B gap, fight back across, and then our bandit's out in the C gap right there. So that's one example right there. So here would be our fox three, where we are going to play a three. We decided per game plan here. Where our star's not going to come, we're just going to exchange it and bring the mic. We're going to drop the safety in to a three buzz look here, and we're going to push through curl flat out here with the star here on this. But the front still showing the buzzard. And then you can see Our bandit is swiping the hip angle of one here. The wheel's working his weak hash drop, bringing the mic. Here's our strong hook out of the safety, and then our curl flat or our skiff player comes out of the star. So our wheel linebacker makes a really nice play here, sees two across on the slow screen, makes a really good play. So you can see the look here, we're showing buzzard. Okay, so our three to the boundaries working to a four eye, nose is picking across, and then our five technique is coming across face. Now our five technique, all right, anytime our reduction hand or our end that's slanting into the ball, if we get hi-hat, he has the option of going two-way go right there on the right guard, so he can go inside or outside. So, but we're still playing just cover three. Now that's our exchange principles where we're bringing the mic now from his, you know, our plus alignments when we plus the trips. And then here's just another example. Okay, we're going to go ahead because of the split of number three. You know, the mic's a little wide here, but we'll plus our backers and relate to three. Anytime we bring the backer, we're going to plus the backers to match the numbers. But we're showing the buzzard front. And we're picking back across. So right here, this would look like our boundary four down look. So you've got 33 who's working to a four eye. Nose is picking across, ends picking across, and we're bringing the star from the boundary here. So what we got to do better on that is it becomes like a two-back set. We got to get the mic back in the box to get over with the pull. But that's what we call Fox. So another look at it here, into the boundary. So we've got our boundary three. We're going to go ahead and show with the bandit, the nose, and the end, and a five. So everybody's picking across here. Okay, not a very good job here by the our defensive end to the field. Okay, we want to try to get across face or take 60. All right, and if we can't get there, we're going to take him and use his body in the gap. Okay, and then he should be a spill player. All right, and he just takes the easy way out right there. So kind of screws it up, but our star comes off the edge unblocked. So, but we spill that out. We've got good fits there. So, but again, still playing coverage, cover three. So, the next one that we get into, just this one's been really good for us, especially, you know, like we game plan cover third downs up and how we manipulate protection. So, we get into our bear front, and what we did here in bear front is we walked the bandit the mic up, and it kind of ties in with our tight front. When we tight front, the bandit is our two dropper, so he's used to dropping on two, and we're bringing the wheel, who, you know, in our tight front sees our daylight rush read or our late rush fourth guy that we're adding in. And then our mics always are three dropper, and we're playing cover four, is how we do it. So, we'll bring the inside backer in this case. So right here, you know, we're a bear, and we caught bills, our NFL teams are kind of our MO for when we're showing, these fronts and we're dropping out. So we'll have different NFL teams we use, but we really live and die in those cover four, cover three. I'm a big proponent of zone coverage and off and using your eyes and coverage. And we do a lot of hot blitz stuff too, where we're working eyes. But you can see here, you know, our bandit should be up. This was a young kid. This was early in the year. He was a 10th grader. It's going to be a really good player for us. He essentially is going to be up from bear, but he's our two dropper. All right. We would bring the nose to the side of the back, and we were bringing the mic away from the back. And then your mic linebackers walked up. Well, he's our three dropper. Okay. Well, three's in the core, so he should be working straight back off of that, unless three were to push, and then he would push with it. So pretty good job. We get a little breakdown here, you know, Our three techniques, okay, in this front, they're going from a three to a four eye, and they're working into our tight front. Well, if we get past, they're supposed to cop out and work contain. We're dropping him on two, we're dropping the mic on three, and we're bringing this extra backer in to the A gap. So typically what we've gotten a lot of, you're going to get a couple things. Big on big protection is what we've been getting. Or you could get slide protection. We have another package for that. So here, the center really doesn't block anybody, I think, you know, haven't seen it early in the year. So that's kind of what it looks like. We're getting the back trying to pick up the mic. Well, the center doesn't stay on the nose. And then we'd like to see, you know, the breakdown comes here where we've got to work our cop where we're contained on pass. So I'd like to see that end work on out when we get that pass and he contains on that pass. So another look at it here again, 2x2, just basic cover four. So we haven't changed anything really between our mic, our star, and our bandit. So they're getting really good drops out here. A really good job right there of working the cover four package right there. And then again, you know, this is a little bit later. Again, center doesn't pick up, doesn't stay on the nose there. So the nose comes free. So, and then, you're going to either get slide protection or you're going to get big on big. So here we get empty, which is really good. So, you know, our mic is our three dropper here. We're playing a mini concept now. So the mic's going to post three. If three is under, we want to take him back. If three is over, we turn it over to the safety. And then our bandit is dropping out on two to the boundary side. So, but now they go big on big, and we get the mic on a free run through here. So your ends again want to go from three to four eye, three to four eye, and then they want to cop out to contain on pass, just like you would if you guys are tight front guys. And then we really want that mic off the line as he opens the three. If three's under, he needs to take that back. So 17 is trying to take that back, and he just missed getting the pick there. So I'd like to see him do a little better job of taking that route back. But we get the mic. We get the mic on a pretty clean run through here. So here we are again in Bear Bills, and we're just playing cover four. So, you know, my mic again is a three dropper. The bandit is our two drop, and we get the mic running through. So now they're throwing fast screen. We're just going to rally to it, but we get a nice run through with the mic. We get the protection that we were counting on getting. We're able to get him free here. So that was one of our things I really enjoyed, like, this year. This is us against IMG Academy this year. So same deal here. We're 2x2, so we've got our mic should be dropping on three here. So if three is in the core, we want to work straight back unless we get a push right there. So we'd like to see him work straight back. All right, and then we get the run through. We get what we want. We just, you know, IMG just had a little better athlete than we do here, and the quarterback gets out, but we get the free run through here. Okay, so kind of a bad job by the three not working to the four eye, where we really want to work to that four eye with our threes. And then so we've got to work to contain here if we get this hi-hat. So really don't like it there, right there. So a couple of young guys in there, so 10th graders are going to get better. But we get the mic free, the wheel free through on the run through. We just don't make the play right there. So, but you can see the protection. So, Something else that we did off of this late in the year in the semifinals, we went Bear Bills bump. And so what we did is we took the wheel through the center where we're going to pick the center off on our track, and then the nose is going to punch and loop off of the wheel on the pick. So this was kind of us working in practice. So for scout team guys here, we're coming through through the center because we thought we were getting this protection leading into the semifinals. You know, we'd already played the team once before, but, you know, I told the center, like, what was about to happen. I told him twice, but to protect himself here. But we get the wheel pushing through, and then we get the nose looping there, and we're freeing the nose up there. So that's a bump call for us off of that. And then we ran it here. We got the same look. We ran it here, but the center slid away. So, you know, the nose, there's no reason to loop when the center slides away and he's coming through. So, again, you know, our three techs got to get to – he's got to work to the contain here. But we do – I think we do end up getting – this was the semifinals here. I think we end up flushing the quarterback and getting the pick here. So, so it's a good pressure package. It's been good to us. So that was bump right there that we worked. And then lastly, I'm just going to go over this so I don't go too much over the time. We'll play a field Niners 3 where we're going to bring the star from the field. All right, this is a sub package for us. We're going to put an extra backer as a defensive end here, take our nose out and leave our two ends in where we're working. We're working the face of the center, okay? We're working to a four-eye from the two-eye here. We're bringing bringing our star nickel off the field edge. This is an A stunt for us where it's tooth or tail stunt. Tackles out, we're under, tackles down, we're coming off his butt. So this is Niners, and it's still cover three package for us. So we're still running cover three. And then our bandit would be, you know, our swipe. So we should be working four eye, face of the center. We're bringing a stunt. We're bringing the nickel off the edge, the nickel star there for us, but still playing cover three. So this IMG here again. So let me go to the butt shot here. So we'll slide the front versus three-man surface to get the three to the three-man surface. So center's back. We want to come across face. We're a stunt. We're bringing the star off the edge here. And then if it were pass, our bandit would be dropping out there. So that, without going too far over, that's just a few things that we do right there that we really like. You know, I think it's important that, you know, that you stay true and you stay with kind of what you do, you know, instead of, you know, we're a zone team with what we do. And, you know, we're gonna live in the cover three and cover four world, and so we're gonna build some things off of that. So that's all I got, Coach. If you guys have any questions, you know, feel free to hit me up anytime, and let's talk about it.